Travis Scott, man, that voice, fire. All right, guys, back at it again. I'm here. Yup, it's me. Same clothes as the last video because recording this on the same day, but dropping this later. So it is what it is. I have time today to do it, so might as well. And then that way I can spend more time editing and, you know, doing cool stuff. But yeah, man. So follow me on Instagram. My name is literally just Jose Perez, the THE, third, like three, and then RD. So very, very simple. Link below. But a name will probably be here. Somewhere. Here. I don't know. Here? I still gotta get used to all the like comments, subscribe, like where they're at. So yeah. Anyway, previous video was like vintage, sort of like recent pickups of what I've been doing. This time, I'm gonna do my designer pickups and kind of like sit back. Well, not kind of, sit back, definitely for sure, because it's gonna be kind of a longer video just because these are designer pickups and they're like, not saying that they're like, oh my God, like, ugh. No, I'm not. But they're things I've wanted for a very, very long time. Being into fashion, I'm sure people can relate. Like when you get something you've always wanted for a very long time, it means a lot, you know? So it's, everyone has a thing, like, whether it's like, I don't know, Magic the Gathering. I don't know where that comes to mind. Or like, you know, like baseball cards, things like that. You know what I mean? Like when you're a collector of something and you get something you've always wanted, it's like a big deal. So that's why it's gonna take a while. So, yeah, man, sit back and get cozy, and we'll get into the video. All right, first up, it's just something I've had. I've had it for a minute. I bought this on my 25th birthday, so recently, like last year. But it's just something I've always wanted, and I almost, like, I got it thinking it was, like, you know when you... I don't know if you ever like know this, but when people like hit a certain milestone in their life, they get like a watch or like, you know, something like that. That's what this was for me. So that's why I got it. I'm not like, ooh, look at me, you know, like, oh, I got this. You know, I'm not. I'm definitely not. Like when I wear this very, very basic. But yeah, Gucci belt. So original packaging is in the closet, so I didn't want to take it all out. I'm gonna show it real quick, just cause, but yeah. That's really not a lot to say about it. I usually just wear this with like, all black. Just like anything else I wear, but I got the silver one cause I tend to wear more silver than I do gold. I don't really like gold that much. So that's just me, Cause I wear black, and black and gold, it's cool, but I don't know, not for me. I feel weird wearing gold. I don't know about you guys. I feel like I'm being way too loud when I wear gold. So, yeah. You definitely get a lot of looks when you're wearing this stuff. Like, I wear this very, very casual too. Like, not like ooh, like big. And this is like the tinier one too, so it's not the big one. At least I think. Pretty sure. Pretty sure, because I bought this off of the Gucci website. But, yeah. I wear a red plane and people are still like, whoa, you're wearing a Gucci belt? Like, yeah. Cool, thanks. Well, yeah. Yeah. Not a lot to say about it, so there's that. And then, just to keep moving it up, keep it going, my bad. Keep it going. Common projects. You guys have heard me talk about these, like, a lot in my videos, so I just thought I might as well just show them off in this video. It's not like something I picked up recently, but I just wanted to show it off because it kind of, it's designer, whatever, you know, kind of designer. You might be able to tell there's certain parts, I'm like leaning all weird. There's certain parts that are like, they feel weird, right? They look weird, right? It's because I repainted the shoe. I've had this shoe for a minute, for a good while, and obviously you can tell, you kind of can tell, there's that sole protector on them, just because I like keeping my shoe clean. Man, I am dying. Jeez, it's the light. This halo light thing I have, I'm not used to it. So if you see me sweating, man's is hot. So that's why. Okay, as I was saying before, I was dying of heat. Yeah, man, very, very clean shoe. I got this when I was in college. Not saying that I'm like still in college, I'm not actually. But yeah, I got these when I was like barely entering college, and it was kind of like I got them because I'm like, oh, well, I'm about to go into college, and I don't want to wear just like white Vans, you know. And at the time, it was when Jacob Keller, aka Always Fresh Apparel, was always talking about Common Projects, and that's literally the reason why I got them, I'm gonna be honest. But because of him, I was like sold on these shoes and like how unique and like how nice, and like the leather is very, very, very like buttery and just very nice. But I've kept up with these shoes and they've obviously held up really nicely, as you can tell. Like, look at that sole. I have replaced the sole, like protector, not the sole itself, but the sole protector quite a few times. But look at that, still clean. And I've had these for like a good amount of time. I think like almost 7 years. No, that's a lie. Probably like 5 or 6 years, maybe almost hitting 6 years this year. But yeah, that's that. So, and what sucks is, so when I was painting them, and I'll have to like touch this up later or something, but see that? Yeah, that's what sucks. But I can clean that up. So I'm all like worried and saying I can clean it up, but it definitely comes off. I just haven't gotten around to it. But ooh, that paint is almost coming off. The reason I show that is because you can kind of see here, I painted over the numbers, which ruins like the what's it called, the value of the shoe. But you can take off the paint and then write it back in there. So yeah. Okay, moving on to the next shoe. Let me just go off of like, they're not recent. These are not the recent ones. I'll tell you what the recent ones are. All right. These right here? Like that. Yep. I take care of my shoes, guys. Like, I really do. Oh, snap. I need to replace that little part right there. It still smells good. I've had these for a while. These I've had for as long as I've had the Common Projects. So, if you're wondering what they are, there's a name. Please don't touch my rail. Yeah, there's not a lot to say about these shoes, just that I wanted them when I learned about Raph Simons. And at the time, this was like obviously when ASAP Rocky was getting big, I'm gonna be honest, but at the time, No one was wearing this shoe. No one had this shoe. I never saw a celebrity wear these. Yeah, it was more of like my own, like just doing research of like Raph Simons archives and things like that, and like learning about Raph Simons as a designer. And this is what happened. This is my first like Raph Simons like pickup. I don't have any like clothes of Raph Simons. Just because, like, I don't know why. I like his designs, don't get me wrong, I do. But I haven't, like, yet to, like, buy a piece of clothing from Raph Simons. That will probably change. I'll probably get, like, the denim shirt with, the, like, the pat, the logo, the, like, the upside down R and the R. Yeah. So, I have the I have the box. It's just in the storage. I don't throw it away. I don't throw away boxes like that. Not with shoes like this. So every time I wear these though, it's funny because people think I'm like, I don't know, maybe I'm like handicapped or something. Because that's like, I'm not trying to be mean, but when people see me wear these shoes and because they're Velcro, they're like, why are you wearing Velcro shoes, bro? Like, what? And you gotta think though, they don't know what this shoe is. Which is like, it's not what I'm going for, obviously. I like it because I like it. It looks like a skate high, but just much more cleaner. Like, and I honestly got these because I wanted an all-black shoe. I wanted an all-black shoe. At the time, I was thinking, I'll just get an all-black Common Project. But, look at that. It feels so nice. I wanted something a little bit more unique. So, that's when I came across these. So, these mean a lot to me. This is my first, like, designer pickup. My designer purchase, I guess you could say. That's why they mean a lot, I guess. Because they were just that first purchase where I was like, ooh, that's a lot of dough at the time. And yeah, so I'll never get rid of them. But I know that in like, is it Singapore? I don't remember. I know there's another release. I think it's like the Europe release. Probably not Singapore. I don't know why that comes to mind, but this right here, this little black plastic part where it's coming out of the strap is silver, which I wish I would have gotten those, but these are fine. They're cool. They're definitely like when you're wearing them, they definitely feel heavy. So, but yeah, there's just the Rav Simmons Velcro. If you type that into Google, you'll find them. They have an all white one. Probably won't get them because I don't need them. I don't. Okay. These right here, next up, are definitely the recent ones. These, most of them are from Christmas gifts from myself and from my fiance, kind of. So let's start with the first one. Yeah, I know. Nike. I wouldn't say it's the like designer. But when I show you the shoe, you'll see why I put it in this video. So, you're like, whoa, what is this? You can probably already tell. Can you? I actually got a real good deal on these. I bought them off Grail, off of someone. And they were authentic, or like, you know how Grail does like that whole like, digital authentic. Authenticity. I bought them off Grail, and they were already like, it already said that they were authentic, so. And plus, I got a note from the guy, but I got the receipt for it, so. There's that. He just took out his address, because, you know, I don't blame him. But yeah, two treats. Just because I use my own, that's why. I've not worn these yet. I plan to wear these in the summer. So, and you're probably already like, you ready? You know. Yeah. The Sakai or Sahai? I don't even know. Pretty sure it's Sakai. But yeah, man. And if you're wondering why this is so bulky right here, it's because I have a shoe tree in there. Like, watch. I'll take it off. And there's that. It's like, but, yeah, man, they're sick. You can see inside there. Haven't worn them. Very, very cool. Still got the laces on the laces. Still got the laces on the laces. yeah, very clean shoe. Very, very sick. I honestly, and like I said in my previous video, where I tend to, like, sometimes I'll see a shoe on someone and I'm like, dang, I want it because I can wear it like that. This was actually not the case. I saw these being released last year, before they were released. There was like an image that Nike had released way before they were going to release. I think they were maybe like, I think maybe it got leaked, I think. I don't think it was like Nike that released it, but I'm pretty sure they got leaked and I saw an image of them. I think if I can find that image, I'll put it up right here. But that image right there, when I saw the shoe, I was like, whoa, man, I've never seen a Nike shoe like that. And I tend to like things that look very vintage, very old school. Like Nike old school stuff with the orange swoosh is always really dope to me. Like, I always think it's the sickest thing. Like old school Nike stuff. So seeing these with the orange swoosh and how like kind of old school it looks, like the waffle sew on them, because they made these before, like way back. Not this design, because these are obviously like, you know, a Sakai collaboration. But yeah, that's what got me. And I honestly didn't think I was gonna get them. But got a little extra cash, you know, did some little side jobs here and there, and I was like, okay, let's do it. So I got a really good deal. So shout out to that guy, Alpha Grill, for sure. He even left me a little note, like I said. So that was nice of him. But yeah, I didn't pay like what StockX is offering them for. I really close to that price for sure. Really close. He knocked off a little bit. I would say I got a good deal, because to me, a good deal is not having to pay what StockX is offering them for. If I got something less than that, to me, that's a good deal. So, yeah, because they kind of run the game for prices right now. That's usually what people base their price off of. So that's why. But yeah, very clean shoe. Tissue lane. Hey. Sorry, guys. Hang on. Say hi to Tux. Hello, Tux. Hello. Say hi to the camera. Okay. I'm gonna get them out, guys. Hang on. I was trying to get the second shit out of here so you can see it. But I did try them on, obviously. What's weird to me, though, which I don't know how I'm gonna do this. You see how there's two laces right here and two laces over here? I didn't know that. I didn't know that it came that way. And how they put those in there is beyond me. So when I clean these, hopefully I never have to. I probably will. But that's going to be hard. Hopefully the holes are big enough. I'm hoping they are, man, because that's crazy to me. I like honestly did not know that. This is the shoe I tried on, obviously, because it has the laces untied. Yeah. Very, very, very cool shoe, man. Very, very cool shoe. I've seen a lot of people on Instagram wear this shoe, though. So I'll definitely be the only one in my area wearing them, though. I know that for a fact. Cause there's sneakerheads around here, but they're not like sneakerheads. Like buying Jordan releases all the time, and buying like Nike releases, Adidas releases. For example, I've only ever seen one person wear Yeezys around here. I live in Utah, so I wonder. But I will say, that's my area. Salt Lake City, which I do go sometimes. A lot of people. I've seen a few people. And we just barely got a store, apparently, that I found out about. They just opened up. That's like kind of like more towards the target market is like sneakerheads and people that buy into like Off-White and Bape and things like that. So that's pretty cool. I can't lie. We don't have anything like that around here. So being able to like have something like that here in where I'm at is really cool. So I'll have to check out that place soon. Maybe you guys can come with me. Vlog, you know, the vlog. I've always been talking about that. So, oh crap! I forgot to put the receipt in there. But yeah, man. Tell me where you guys live. Not like specifically. Don't tell me exactly where you live. Just tell me like what areas, and then like if there's like sneaker stores like that. Like I know there's like Round Two. There's a ton of stores in California. Ton of them. But where we're at here in Utah. Speaking of Utah. No, it's like this, right? Or is it like this? Yeah, it's like this. I'm forgetting what it looks like. What does Utah look like? It's not like this, and it's not like this. It's like this. It's definitely like this. I'm gonna check after this video, but I'm pretty sure the pattern of Utah is like in this shape. That's funny. The shape of Utah, not the pattern. Yeah. So, cool. Sakai shoes. If you follow me on Instagram, I've definitely posted about these things already. So. If you'll check right now,
you should
follow me
right here.
You'll see what I'm gonna talk about next. Yeah. You're probably wondering where that band is at. It's inside here. This wraps around the whole case. There's dust bags in here. Did you guys hear that Alexander McQueen is not gonna do dust bags anymore? Because they want to preserve the trees and stuff like that, which is cool, don't get me wrong. But that's kind of cool. I just, like, for me though, for me, this is just me. Don't hate on me, okay? But I get why. I definitely, it's not good. I get why they did this. I do. I like preserving my shoes, you know? So I guess I could always just buy like a dust bag off of Amazon if I needed one. But if I ever bought like a designer shoe, like even my common projects come with dust bags. So when I buy a designer shoe, like a quality shoe that's supposed to last me a long time, I want to put it in like storage. I want to put it in a dust bag and keep it safe, you know? So that's just me. I completely understand. If people want to preserve trees, I'm all for that myself. Recycling is something we should do. But that is a topic for a different kind of conversation. So, that little orange piece is still here for some reason. The shoe. The boot. This boot. Me, though, which is kind of cool. It has a little Tiffany jewel on here. I'm going to call it that. I don't like wearing it with the harness. I wear it without it. So I've actually yet to wear these, mostly because I just I don't know. I really don't know why. Like, I know how to wear them. I know what I want to wear with it, but I guess in my mind, it's like, I don't know. Do you guys ever get that? Do you guys ever get a feeling like that? You buy something that you've always wanted, but then you don't even wear it right away. Maybe it's because I just want to preserve it and save it for a long time. I even got soul protectors on these guys. That's how crazy I'm about these shoes. Okay, to explain my reasoning behind the purchase and to preserve the shoe. You see, me growing up as a kid, my dad, I guess, like, I'm brown, right? So I'm Mexican. You guys know what a paisa is? So look it up, Google it real quick. I'll give you like 5 seconds. Pause the video, go look what paisa is. Anyways, he would dress like that, basically. He would wear like a rancher hat, like a cowboy hat. And this is in Texas, of course. So he'd wear like bootcut jeans and then like some like snakeskin boots or like crocodile alligator boots, right? Not like the super pointy ones, though. Like they go all the way up. No, just like nice point. Or sometimes I remember specifically seeing him in a boot had the flat toe. And I remember him buying them too. And I was a little kid. I was like 4, maybe 5. It's a crazy memory to think about. But yeah, that's like why. That's why. And not to get like all sentimental and like, oh, my story's so sad. Like, not at all. I just, you know how it is, man. I'm sure people can relate to something like that where you see your dad or like someone you looked up to wear something and you're like, dang, man, like, I want to dress like him when I grow up. You know what I mean? So I guess that's where this comes from. That's that. I don't want to like get way too into that, but that's probably why I like the whole Western look kind of thing, or like the cowboy look, you know? That's probably where it comes from. That being said, when Raf Simons designed these with Calvin Klein, I saw these and I was like, whoa. Wow. You cannot tell me. This boot, forget about the designer, forget about the brand, but just the boot itself. If you saw someone wearing these without the harness or with the harness, tell me these are not safe. Go ahead. You'd be like, whoa, man, that person knows how to dress real well. Exactly. But very sick. Metal toe. Very nice. Very beautiful. Very sleek. I'm talking about these boots for way too long. Yeah. I'm sure people have seen these. I'd say this is probably like my favorite boot to release. Of was it last year? 2019? Or was it 2018? Whoa! I'm tripping, guys. I don't even know. Hold up. Dang. Ta-da. I don't even know, guys. I'm gonna be honest. There's no number on here that says like the year, because I know sometimes like designers will put that in their shoes. But yeah, I forget. If you know, put it down. I'll probably research it after I finish this video. So yeah, probably the best boot to come out that year when it came out. Pretty sure it was last year though, because I'm pretty sure that's when Calvin Klein departed ways from Calvin Klein, or Calvin Klein departed ways from Raf Simons. So, yeah, just very sick. I definitely plan to hang on to these for the rest of my life, just because, yeah, they're very amazing boot. And it wasn't like, you know how I said I usually, like, sometimes I'll see someone wear it, and I'm like, oh, I want to get it too. Or sometimes I'll, like, actually do the research myself, or, like, see it on the runway, or something like that, you know? With this, it was more of, like, when I saw them being released, I was like, well, I need these. I want these. And then eventually, like, freaking ASAP Rocky wore them to the Met Gala. I think his, like, whole group, his ASAP Mob group, did, like, a Calvin Klein commercial at the time. And they were all wearing these boots. So, but I like them a lot. I'm definitely going to wear them for, like, the rest of my life, probably. Okay, that was a lot of talking about some boots. I apologize, guys. Last one, and we are done. Okay, big box coming through. So, yeah, when you see them, just remember, I like fashion. Big box. Mm-hmm. Yep, you already saw it. And my cat decided to, as you saw earlier, he had a little wet paw, and he got on the box once, and then now it has like that little damage on it. But it's whatever. I mean, I plan to have these shoes for the rest of my life, so it's not like I'm gonna sell them. But if I ever did, that would suck. Tote bag, in case you're wondering. Where does this fit? Right here. I'm gonna see if you guys can even see that. There's that. I don't actually use this. I should. Because, you know, I'm an e-boy. I'm just kidding, I'm not. That's a joke. I don't have the cross-earring. I'm not. Okay. Yeah, here's the shoe. Very clean. I keep these clean. I keep them very clean. Every time I clean some shoes, I clean these. So as you can tell, they're like crispy. They're like brand freaking new. I've worn these. I have, believe it or not. I always say I barely wear some of these things that I get, but I have worn these a lot. But I obviously do keep them clean. No sole protector because of the fact that it has that, like, almost like that Fila disruptor sole to them, like this right here. But the shark tooth, they call it the shark tooth sole, I think. But I always clean it with my, what's it called? Rishunavir? Yeah. Those brushes. Yeah, man. There's not really a lot to say about this Converse. It's a joke. There's Rick Owens, if you can see him. Yep. The man himself. What sucks about this shoe is when you wear this shoe, two things would happen. One, which is weird actually, I never thought this would happen. Because usually, I'm used to wearing let's say I wear the Common Projects, right? People would be like, yo, that's a cool shoe. Like, where'd you get that shoe from? I just tell them it's called Common Projects. And they're like, oh, I've never heard of that before. You know, like, people don't know. I'm sure people can relate, but with this shoe, you know how, like, sometimes you buy, like, a designer piece or something, and you wear it out, and people are like, what are you wearing? Like, what is that? What the fudge? Like, right? I mean, people, like, kind of, like, dog you for it. They kind of make fun of you for liking fashion. That's the dumbest thing, bro. That's a topic for another video. Anyway, when I wear these, two things happen. One, people are like, yo, those are cool. Where'd you get them? And they're actually like, they think it's like actually a cool shoe. Like, I honestly expected to wear this shoe and people would be like, what are you wearing? What kind of shoe is that? They look like clown shoes. They look like Converse. I really thought that's what was going to happen. But I have yet to come across someone like that. Someone has like literally come up to me and they're like, yo, dude, where'd you get these shoes at? Like, they look pretty cool. But yeah, I was not expecting that, honestly. So that's pretty cool. Second thing that happens is someone actually does think that they're like a Converse, like redone or something. They think they're like, oh, are those Converse, but just like different or something? So I've gotten that. People at work, at my job, they know what this shoe is to me because I bought it at work. Like, I'm gonna tell you a little story right now, and hopefully I don't get like taken down by the government or something. Some serious stuff. So I was at work, and this is back when Black Friday was coming up, right? And you know how Essence has their sales and stuff? Yep, I got them off Essence. And for some reason, they marked these down really low. I'm not going to say how much I paid for them because I'm kind of scared to say. Let me see if there's a receipt in here. I don't think there is. I have the receipt, like, screenshotted on my phone. I think it's here. Oh! Extra laces. No, that's it. There's no receipt. I should have kept the receipt. Oh my gosh. That's probably not good. Then again, I plan to keep the shoe forever, so it's whatever. I keep telling that to myself. Yeah, it comes a little like, you know, that. Anyway, what I paid for these shoes is a little bit unbelievable. I don't want to say how much because I just don't want that to be this kind of channel, you know? I'm all for like deals. I'm all for like talking about like, yo, you got a good deal on it? That's dope, dude, you know? But I don't want this to be like, he spends a lot of money on his shoes. So, yeah, kind of crazy how much I spent on them. Well, it is, but for what it is, usually it's more. So, that being said, when I bought them, I checked out like super quick, and then I go back, right? Because I'm like, is this too true? Is this like too good to be true? I go back on the Essence website, and the price had then been changed for a lot more. But it was still on sale, but they changed it. I think what happened was they messed up. I think Essence messed up when they put these on sale, and I went and I bought them right away because I don't think they thought that someone was gonna buy them right away for how much they marked it down. Or maybe they did, who knows? But they did, I took advantage of it. And then as soon as I did, they raised that price up, but still saying that it was like on a sale. Cause usually these are like what? I don't even know, honestly. I think they're like 12, 11 maybe, 1100. Again, not trying to like, you know, show off anything. I can't remember how much they really are. I did not pay that. I paid way, way less for that. So yeah, I got lucky, and I always tell people that. But the reason I bring that up is because I was at work when that happened, and then everyone at work was like, whoa, I showed them what I bought, and they're like, whoa, you spent that much on a shoe? Like, what the fuck? But yeah, obviously some people, like, people that are not into fashion, they don't spend that much on clothes, whereas people like you and me, who's watching this, you probably would at one point in your life. You know, you'd be like, okay, it's a shoe I really want or a piece I really want. I'll spend that much. So, yeah, that's why they know how much it is. And, like, they're always like, oh, Jose's got those shoes on, you know. But, yeah, pretty cool, man. Pretty cool. Pretty excited to have these in my shoe collection that I have, my vast collection of clothes and shoes. I've always wanted these for sure. Rick Owens is like, he's a weird designer. You can't like deny that. He's weird. But he's a cool weird. Yeah. Not saying that I would like wear all his designs, because there's no way. Look at me. I'm not like tall and skinny, you know, so, or even so, like, I'm not like muscular. Whereas like his models tend to be like tall and like skinny, but somehow still like really muscular. I don't know how, but that's his like designs. I would say that's like who his designs are for that kind of body type. But still, man, I still like his art. I still like his designs. His cargo pants, like I don't even think they're called the cargo pants. I forget what they're called. I don't know what they're called, honestly. But I would want those to wear with these. Dope. So, yeah, man. That's really it, though. I don't have anything else. But I just wanted to show you guys my recent designer pickups that I've been getting. Mostly because I've been, like, I got a little extra cash for Christmas and stuff. And that's kind of what I picked up. And I've been trying to buy things that I've always wanted. Just because, this might sound dumb, because like you're thinking about it and you're like, how would you do that? I'm about to have a kid, believe it or not. So I want him to like, I don't want him. But I think it's cool, because you know how like I gave the story about these with like my dad? I kind of want him to be able to like grow up and be like, oh man, my dad, dude, he was a well-dressed man. And that's what got me into fashion. You know? So that's like, in my head, that's kind of where I'm coming from with my purchases. Like, I'm getting these things I've always wanted, and in that way, he can grow up and then work towards those things that he's always wanted, and, you know, get what he wants, not what I want, obviously. But anyway, that's a whole different kind of conversation. Sun's coming down. It's probably like, what, barely 4 o'clock? So, anyway, until next time, guys, definitely follow me on Instagram. Yep, I'm going to plug myself, Jose Perez III. I'll put the little ding right here. And just keep it locked. Subscribe for sure. Like the video. And then that way I can make some more videos for you guys and do some like whatever, you know, whatever comes to mind. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see where it goes. All right, guys. Till next time. Sorry for the long video, but it is what it is. You know, I'm sure if you purchased things that you wanted, you'd probably have a lot to say about them. So that's why I'm here. I keep looking outside because there's like this weird person just like outside over there. Anyway. All right. Till next time, guys. Peace, man.